The Super Bowl spotlight shined on a super screw-up tonight, a ticket fiasco that serves as a lesson when the game comes to Indianapolis next year.
Yeah, this was huge. It was a fitting end to a difficult week of bad weather and bad luck for organizers in Dallas. Fox 59's Eva Pilgrim joining us now live from Cowboy Stadium with more on how fans from Indy actually lost their seats to the big game. And Eva, I can't even imagine that happening.
Yeah, the battle on the gridiron started first with a fight for fans to get in. Diehard fans, season ticket holders, turned away. They won their seats in an NFL lottery for Super Bowl seats. They're turned away because the fire marshal said an entire section of temporary seating was unsafe. They never even got a look inside, never even saw the field. Fans came from all over the country.
Hey, I live in Chicago.
Connecticut.
Paid big money.
Ours were $2,700.
We paid $2,400 a seat.
For a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
I grew up in Green Bay. My first Super Bowl.
You really looked forward to that.
I did. It's my team. The NFL is screwing us over.
About 2,500 fans given tickets to the NFL lottery found out today that their seats were no good.
Please be advised that due to unforeseen conditions, the installation of temporary seating for Super Bowl is not fully completed and your seat assignment is unavailable for today's game.
Nobody knows what's going on. Nobody knows what's going on at all.
How long did you have to prepare and you didn't prepare?
You gotta be joking.
I'm really irritated. I for 2 hours was forced to walk around the stadium when our whole plan for today was to try to minimize my walking as much as possible.
Angry fans demanded seats.
Yeah, somebody no should be down here.
And answers.
I don't know.
As they tried to get into the game.
We spent tens of thousands of dollars to come here, and you're telling me you want to shut the game up. Don't look at us. We're the paying customer.
I understand. You'll be okay.
I understand. We'll be okay.
Forced to wait.
Jerry sucks! Jerry sucks!
Jerry, why is my seat no good?
Tempers growing.
We want our seats! We want our seats!
As for many, their patience runs out.
Somehow I think people think this is funny.
After hours of waiting, finally an answer.
4:30.
Once in, a few fans were taken to their seats, some to a field level box to watch the game on a TV. An Indianapolis man was among the over 850 to watch the game on the TV from the basement of the stadium here in Dallas.
I'm coming here as a football fan to see this wonderful stadium. And you know what? I've still yet to see the field, and I've still yet to see this 100-yard or 100-foot TV screen.
He's one of the lucky ones. About 400 people never got a seat. A Super Bowl these fans won't soon forget.
But this little Packers fan is going to have quite a story to tell.
Now, the NFL did deliver apologies to those fans, and they are giving refunds. Those who actually got to sit in their seats will get face value for their inconvenience, and the people who watched it from downstairs in the basement on the TV will get three times the value. Those who didn't even get to come into the game will also get three times the value. But many fans are telling us they spent much more than that to be here. In Dallas, Eva Pilgrim, Fox 59 News.